Hello, good evening. This is your Lola Amalia once again. I'm going to blog tonight about a woman who I respect very much, as well as my children respect very much. The ninang of my daughter, Christine, and son-in-law, Raylan, a mentor, no? A colleague in the university then, and ika nga, a woman of wisdom. We have not heard from her for quite a time since the pandemic. The last time we heard about her was when she was sick, and Denise informed us of her condition. Since then, we did not hear anything anymore from Denise or receive any news about this woman. This woman is Dr. Rustica Carpio, na I refer to as a gem of a woman. In this article, this is an article I wrote for her, and para to sa isa sa mga libro niya, no, na na-publish. And I would like to share it with you for you to know the kind of a woman, the genius that Dr. Carpio is. Let me start reading this for you. It was a poignant moment as the veteran actress playing Doña Teodora delivered her last lines in the play Calamba, 1888. And let me do it as if I am Rustica Carpio, but I know I cannot definitely be her because she is a very good actress. Just trying. Wala na siya. Nawala na siya sa aking paningin. Hindi ko na siya muli pang makikita. The actress sobbed. The audience empathized with her. The lights went out. Total darkness followed. Then a deafening applause ensued. The actress, Dr. Rustica Carpio, is a name respected in Philippine arts and letters. She is a distinguished academician, performing artist of stage, film, and television, a soprano, a writer, and translator. Referred to as the female Bob Hope of the Philippines, she being the first Filipina to boost the morale of Filipino troops in Korea during the Korean War, she is a prolific writer. She has to her credits more than 200 articles, critiques, reviews, poems, plays, and short stories. These literary pieces found publication not only in the Philippines but also abroad. A literary genius, she has written and published more than a dozen books on literature, speech, and communication. Dr. Carpio's exposure to theater, the academe, and the movie world provided her the experiences and the wisdom to write and dwell authoritatively on these fields. As a writer, she does not hesitate to point out the message which she wants her readers to absorb. Writing about the modern drama in the Philippine theater, she courageously pointed out the need for artists who are self-sacrificing, courageous, less materialistic, hardworking, and if possible, gifted and trained for the theater. In another article she wrote with Dr. Anacleta Encarnacion, entitled Cheating, Academic Waywardness, she emphasized the need for a better understanding of the real tenets and purposes of education and for students to strive for honor, the honorable way, not the despicable manner, since the diploma is a token of hard work and not a tool for malicious and corrupt aspirations. Here on Wings of Music is one literary piece, the beautifully crafted sentences of which, such as music, is the nourishment of the body, the vitamin of the brain, the purifier of the soul, the healer of souls that are tormented, of hearts that crave for life and love, will bring its readers to such feeling of wanting to experiment the effects that music can do to a person. Indeed, Dr. Carpio is a literary genius whose thoughts and ideas must be read by the present generation. The publication of this book, yung libro niya, Her On Wings of Music, which contains her gems of wisdom for the last 50 years, is a timely tribute to a woman every Filipino of which must be proud of. So I'm happy that I wrote this particular article for her and included in that particular book that she had written. And I have worked with Dr. Carpio not only as a co-professor in the university, not only as a subordinate when I was dean of the graduate school of PUP and she was teaching there. I worked with her in the theater. When I was producing, when I was still producing plays, the first person I got for my second production, Kalamba 1888, was Dr. Carpio, who played the role of Doña Teodora Alonso, the mother of Dr. Rizal, and she did the role very, very well. She was very professional, and nakakahiya if we were not early in our in the schedule of our rehearsals, because she was always there, ayos na rin, at saka kung ano yung dapat na gamitin damit, yun ang kanyang suot-suot. Kahit rehearsal pa lang kami kasi nung kasama namin si Dr. Carpio, parang performance na kaagad yung ginagawa namin. So, ganun kasi, kasama mo ay tunay na mga artista sa puso, that is how you will do it. And the stage is different. The different venue to definitely express yourself. Iba-iba ang stage. So nakasama ko si Dr. Carpio and nakasama ko siya sa maraming sa mga organisasyon. Nakasama ko siya sa mga seminars namin. Magkasama kami sa Bicol. And nakakatuwa, when we were in Bicol, may mga bata na tinginan-tingin sa kanya when we were doon, nandun kami sa isang simbahan, nagpicture-picture kami. There are children na titingin-tingin sa kanya, nagbubulungan sila, sabi. Narinig ko sila sabi, "Lola, Lola." And that was the film done by Dr. Carpio, where she played the Lola. And she was recognized. And so, nagpa-picture yung mga bata kay Lola, kay Dr. Carpio. And talagang Dr. Carpio is a woman every woman should be proud of. And I hope we will be hearing something about Dr. Carpio. Ano na ang kalagayan niya ngayon, para naman kahit paano, alam natin na makasama niya sa teatro, kasama niya sa film, kasama niya sa akademya, this particular difficult times in our lives as this pandemic is still here with us. So this is not definitely I really love talking about Dr. Carpio. I really love to reminisce the days we were together, and that was even at that started at PUP during the early 80s when she was there as director of the University Center for Culture and the Arts, and then as dean of the College of Communication. So I work with her in the academe, I work with her in the theater, I work with her in many organizations, and ours is yung aming tandem na ganon ay isang very healthy working relationship between somebody who is much older than I am, and parang nanay ko na siya kasing edad siya ng nanay ko eh. And Dr. Carpio is definitely deserving. Matagal na lagi namin siyang ininonominate noon sa National Artist for Theater, National Artist for Literature, several nominations na. Hindi pa nga lang siya nakakaswerte na makuha yung recognition na yon. The National Artist for Literature, National Artist for Theater. So, that is all about Dr. Carpio. Thank you very much for viewing my blog, my YouTube channel. And I hope with this blog, you will know that this woman, Dr. Rustica C. Carpio. Good evening. Take care. God bless you all. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Just Me, Amalia. God bless you. I love you all.